Wasn't that awesome? Wasn't that fast?
Well, wow. Praise the Lord.
That is good. How's everybody doing out there? I hope everybody's blessed. I hope everybody's at their best right now. And I just want to make this short video right here. I'm on Levy, Montana right now. Just being a servant, being a vessel for the Lord, for the kingdom. For we're living in tough times, and we need to be just like what Jesus says in the Great Commission, all power and honor in heaven is given to me. Therefore, go to the ends of the world and make disciples and baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe everything that I have taught you. Till then, I'll be with you to the end of ages. See, that was the Great Commission that our Lord and Savior, his last words that he gave to his disciples. That all power in heaven and earth is given to him. For he is the creator. He is God. Elohim El Shaddai. He is God, the creator of the heavens and the earth. And all authority is his. So he commands us to go to the ends of the world and to make disciples. There's a big message right there that he commands us. To make disciples, not to be idle, not to be hearers and not doers of the word, not to be lukewarm, not to be cold, not to be ashamed of the gospel. There's no time for that, no time, no excuses. Jesus is coming. He's a faithful God, and he tells us in his word that just like the lightning flashes from the east to the west, that's how it's gonna be when he comes. So I hope you got Jesus. I hope you got Jesus. I hope you got Jesus. I hope you are filled with his Holy Spirit that dwells in our hearts. For we ought to be on fire, proclaiming, shining, sharing the message of salvation, making disciples to the ends of the world, teaching them to observe everything that he had taught us. See, he had taught us to love, but many people think the love is to love the sin. It's not. We are to repent of our sin, to turn away, and to turn away completely and not go back to our sinful life, and to be filled with his anointing Holy Spirit and be led and strengthened and encouraged daily by his Holy Spirit. We are to love our brother as ourselves, not the sin. Because people put brothers and sisters in our path to share the love and the message of salvation. And by staying quiet, by being ashamed, by putting all these excuses in the dictionary, not to be obedient to his word, but to be obedient to the enemy by loving the world and loving the sinful life of the world. Really? For if you love the world, the love of the Father is not in you. You can't serve two masters. You can't. You either gotta serve God or serve the enemy. And you know who's the ruler of this world? It's the enemy. This world will be destroyed, will be no more. For God is coming. We're living in the end of the last days, brothers and sisters. We don't have no time to put excuses, to be obedient, and to be proclaiming the truth, and to be shining the light. Brothers and sisters, just like you saw the train pass by right now, that was quick. That was fast. You think you could jump on the train? You think you could jump? I wouldn't even try it because I know that those tracks will cut me up, slice me up. So when Jesus comes, he's going to come that quick, just like lightning flashes from the east to the west. So it's like the train. If we're not in a solid relationship with our Lord and Savior, we're not going to be on the train, and we're not going to be able to get up on the train. We're not going to be able to jump, and there's going to be no second chances. No forgive me, no I'm sorry, no excuses. For if you deny the Son here on earth, you will not make it into heaven. So I just want to let you know, guys, that I love you. And I'm reaching out to you. Whoever's watching this video. Whoever's watching this video. If you don't have Jesus, repent of your sins. Repent of your sins. For if you repent of your sins and confess that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead on the third day, you should be saved. And invite him into your life to take over. Because without him, we can't do it. We can't. There's no way. He is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through Jesus Christ. That's John 14:6. So, I love you, brothers. And Jesus loves you. And that's what matters. That Jesus loves us. Amazing grace. He gave it all for us. I hope you surrender to Jesus and obey Jesus. Love you.
God bless.